El premio Frontera de Conocimiento en el área de Ecología y Biología de la Conservación a los profesores Rosemary y Peter Grant ha reconocido su enorme trabajo documentando cómo funciona, cómo trabaja la evolución en zonas naturales, en la naturaleza.
So I think the most important thing that we've learned from the Grant's amazing long-term study of the finches of the Galapagos is not just that genetic variation is important for the maintenance of a species. And we know that. It's a part of diversity that's within a species as opposed to across species. But that it has to be protected, that new species can bring new genetic information in that can lead to the origin of new species in relatively rapid time. And that means we need to have, you know, the opportunity for dispersal to occur. And we've learned how rapidly species can respond to environmental change when that genetic variation is there to allow those changes to occur. So I think it helps us better understand how important it is to conserve genetic variation to allow the potential for species to both adapt and evolve.
Lo que nos muestra es como una radiografía perfecta, yo diría incluso una tomografía de alta calidad de cómo se genera una especie nueva. Y el resultado más sorprendente es que esa generación de especies puede ocurrir muy rápidamente como respuesta a esos cambios que son muy bruscos.
But to me, I think the most profound message is that how crucial evolution is as a process in maintaining diversity in nature.
So we have taken very much the dynamic responses, the physiological responses of species to determine the impacts. And I think the importance of the work of Rosemary and Peter Grant is very much that they add to that view a evolutionary perspective. So if we take that into account, it helps us to understand the changes and how species respond.
Dentro de biología de conservación, la implicación más directa es la de mostrar cómo puede operar la selección natural. Es decir, que en biología de conservación, hasta hace relativamente poco tiempo, en que investigadores como los Grant pusieron de manifiesto que la evolución podía acontecer muy rápidamente, no éramos conscientes de cómo podíamos usar esa herramienta para conservar especies. ¿Cómo podemos asistir a los mecanismos evolutivos, por eso se llama evolución asistida, para promover la conservación de especies?
I think what is really fascinating is their endurance and their ability to choose a question and then really keep on working on it and trying to understand the system in ever more detail and utilizing new methods and just keep on working on that one big problem about how do species evolve and what are the processes, the mechanisms. And they're also inspiring because they're great communicators. The way they're able to relate their research to broader audiences is also, I think, it's masterful and inspiring. And I read about them when I started to study, and I think there are many, many people in biology and across, you know, different disciplines who think the way they're communicating their science and also how they do their science with this perseverance, this love for detail, the accuracy, the patience, that's all just wonderful.
I think it is really beautiful to see this story unfold over 40 years of detailed study and to discover that we can learn, you know, more about evolution in a place where it's been studied for longer than anywhere else. You know, that long-term study always leads to new insights and that there's always more to learn. And the longer and the deeper the focus, the more beautiful and deeper the results turn out to be.